How do I skip the ad?
Today's show is brought to you by...
Wait a minute, am I the ad? If it'll give me paid, I'll scream and shout. Drink a White Claw with the label out. Wanna feel like you won the lotto? Get yourself a local California avocado. What am I saying? I pray it don't last. But I'm cool for 48 hours, like a hydro flask. Oh my God, what's happening to me? Did you see the lineup on TLC? Soon I'll be stacking checks, each hand written with a tube of Blistex. I'm a beginner, beginning thinner, eating ginger for dinner. That spice will have me coming out of winter, a winner, like I used Terrible Ant Killer. But I'm no sinner, trying to warm my feet, I'm tucked into my fitted sheet. Jelly belly, 99 cents on the dollar, got me feeling so sweet, I simply must holler. Sitting on my wallet, cause it keeps getting taller. Call me a good boy, why necklace for a collar? Rapping so hard, may I lost me friends. Least I still have Dole Juice blends. I promise you a laugh, but that might be a lie. But I can guarantee we're sponsored by...
The following is intended only for mature audiences. Viewer discretion advised.
All right, everyone, let's get this meeting started. I'm looking forward to hearing your nursery rhyme pitches for tomorrow's focus group. The little kiddos are going to love them. I'm expecting excellence from each and every one of you. So who's up first? All right, Alex, let's hear from you.
I wrote about a fun time I had with my kids this weekend. It goes, five little monkeys jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said, no more monkeys jumping on the bed.
Oh no, then what?
Oh, well, then the song just continues down a number until all of the little monkeys fall off the bed and bump their heads.
And what lesson is learned?
It's a nursery rhyme, Cam. There's really no conclusion.
The mom let her monkeys jump after the doctor said not to? How irresponsible. They could get hurt. They could get a concussion.
Okay, you leave my kids and my parenting out of this, please.
I didn't say...
What a lovely song, Alex. I'm sensing Thank great you. Potential with this one.
Thank you so much.
Can I get another pitch? Jamie.
Yeah, it's really funny. My pitch also has to do with bumping your head.
No way.
We're on like the same wavelength today. Crazy. Mine has to do with my grandfather. May he rest in peace. Here it goes. It's raining, it's pouring, the old man is snoring. He went to bed and bumped his head and couldn't get up in the morning.
That is so catchy.
Right?
Couldn't get up in the morning?
Yeah, it's he passed away in his sleep.
That is very catchy. An old man dying from bumping his head will make us millions.
Yeah.
Well, I wrote another song about someone getting hurt, actually.
Nope.
Yeah,
I also wrote another song.
You did?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
You go first.
I just roll. Okay.
You're
gonna love it. I promise. It's about this ambiguous figure who falls off a wall, and ultimately nobody can put it back together again.
I'm picturing an egg.
Yeah, it's definitely an egg. It couldn't be anything else.
It's actually about my husband's. It's
my turn.
You've talked enough.
Okay. My song is a true story. It's about my twin siblings, Jack and Jill. And so they went up a hill and it was crazy. So Jack like tripped and fell down and he like broke his head, you know, like, owie. And then Jill tried to help him, but then was also pulled into the abyss. Crazy.
I'm so sorry to hear that. Anyway, our company is hosting a focus group tomorrow for children, and you all think that this is...
Clearly, pain makes the big bucks. Kids love it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Can I give my pitch now? This is a very inspirational song about facing challenges and never giving up. It's called the Itsy, Bitsy, Spider.
That is beyond inappropriate.
You have bugs in your house, Cam? Ew.
Disgusting. What? Get an exterminator.
Yeah.
Moving on. Pain.
My song, yes. So my son actually wrote this song a while ago, and we've been singing it together every night since. So here's how it goes. Rock-a-bye baby on the treetop. When the wind blows, the cradle will rock. When the bough breaks, the cradle will fall. And down will come baby, cradle and all. Isn't it peaceful? Look, here's a really cute picture of us.
So what, the baby falls out of the tree and then what, it dies?
Duh.
Cam, don't you get it? That sells. Let's get some more.
Oh, I can sing my other song. So this one will be so fun for the kids. They'll all hold hands in a circle and spin around and around until they all die at the end. And it goes, ring around the rosy, pocket full of posies, ashes, ashes, we all fall down.
Oh my gosh, that is brilliant. It's interactive. It's, oh my gosh, that's so fun.
We love a group activity.
Oh yes, cremated children. Riley, did your son inspire this one too?
Oh yes. He is so talented. He always tells me about his past life in the Black Plague. What an imagination! I actually have a video of him singing another song that he wrote. If you want to watch that.
Okay, son, I navigated the tricky part. It's all lined up. Now all you gotta do is drive straight through.
Okay, Dad. I got this, Dad. You think I got this, Dad?
You got this. No problem, son. All you gotta do is drive straight.
Okay.
Okay, you've hit the edge. It's okay. Just back up. Just back up a bit.
Oh, no. Dad, we're stuck.
That's all right. Just turn the wheel 180 degrees.
Dad, there's people behind us, and they can't get past because we're stuck.
It's fine. You gotta build some momentum.
Dad.
Hey, hon. You'd be so proud of your son. He is handling a very stressful situation.
Dad?
Yeah, no, okay. Okay, yeah. No, okay. No, yeah. Okay, we gotta go. I'll call you after. Tell you how it goes. Okay, yeah, bye. Okay, yeah, love you. Yeah. No, Totino's is fine. Okay, bye-bye. We're gonna have Totino's.
We're holding everyone up and I can't get it unstuck.
Son, I have every faith in you to figure this out. You're smart. Oh, look, we're memes. To memes. Oh, that's funny. It's got a little digger next to the big boat.
Oh, no. Do you think Rachel saw all of this?
Who it is, if it isn't the local criminal.
Well, if it isn't the other local criminal. Didn't reckon I run into you, partner.
Well, here I am, partner.
This town ain't big enough for the both of us.
Hi, sorry to interrupt, but the town only has 245 people in it, which technically would make it large enough for both of you.
How do you know how many people are in this town?
I'm with the government. I'm here to conduct the U.S. Census.
The U.S. sent us?
No, they sent me. Now I just count how many people are here, and then I go and I tell them.
I do reckon that sounds accurate. Well.
I do declare that I am quite bewildered to find you here in my presence, partner.
I sure was bamboozled to see you here in these parts, partner.
partner.
By these parts, do you mean the Williamson Township or the larger Phillipston County?
I mean these parts.
We're just right by a municipal line, so it just... Never mind.
As I was saying, my due witness, you might have traveled mighty longer than a horse's tail to end up here talking to me, partner.
Why, yes. I rode my noble steed Petunia here, partner.
I'm back. What year, make, and model is your noble steed, and are you up to date with your insurance?
What is insurance?
Who am I?
Madam, we'd really appreciate it if you leave us alone to the business we must attend to.
Of course, yes. I'll just wait until you're finished.
Thank you there, darling. Now, as I was saying, how dare these step these foots into my parts?
It's public property. It belongs to the city.
Partner.
I merely traveled to acquire a wee morsel of corn to feed my family, partner.
You saying that my family's just a star?
Hey, there's plenty of food to go around, you guys. Literally everyone that lives here is a farmer.
Partner.
I do declare that I do desire that all you and your family have to eat for the evening supper is the shame I've brought upon your crest, partner.
I shall not reckon the carnation with you on this, partner.
I reckon you be fancying a shootout, partner.
Whoa, are those registered?
I do declare, partner.
Oh boy. Population 243.
For far too long, conservative women have had to forego pleasure in order to avoid the evil, liberal media-dominated vibrator industry. Not anymore. The Patriot is the first vibrator for conservatives, by conservatives. Made in America, and it is tested on animals. The Patriot, made by Adam and Eve, not Adam and Steve, comes in original red, white, and blue for your patriotic pleasure. And just in time for the holidays, green and gold so you can fight back against the war on Christmas. The Patriot vibrates to 5 patriotic tunes, including the Star Spangled Banner and courtesy of the Red, White, and Blue by Toby Keith. But don't take my word for it. Just listen to these celebrity testimonials.
I, Megan McCain, co-host of The View, love this vibrator. It is not just a diversity hire, it is qualified for the job.
My husband, Donald J. Trump, has never made me orgasm, but the Patriot has gotten me closer than ever before. Be best.
But that's not all. The Patriot is fully equipped to call 911 for you, so you can focus on yourself for a change.
Hello, 911. There is a black man.
And it's a gun, so you can stand your ground like a true American. And for a limited time only, each Patriot order comes with a complimentary butt plug that looks like an elephant tail. Call now and order your very own Patriot vibrator today and make America come again.
Good work, Mother.
Thank you all for coming today. I know it would have meant a lot to my father. My father was a complicated man, and he was a misunderstood man. I know a lot of people, even people here, made assumptions about my dad that were wrong, that didn't describe him at all. People called him snaky. People called him cold-blooded. He was a complicated man, but he was still a man. Things that were said about him, accusations that were leveled, a lot were unfair, off base, scientifically incorrect. My father was not a blue-tongued skink. I remember at school, all the bullying, the taunting. Your dad's a lizard. Your dad eats bugs. Your father is one of the largest members of the skink family hailing from Australia. Yeah. My dad was from Australia. So was Nicole Kidman. And did he have a broad, distinct head? Sure. So does John Travolta. And yes, his tongue was blue. And sometimes he would stick it out as sort of a bluff warning to ward off predators. Okay, sure, who doesn't? It makes me sick to think people thought my dad was a viviparous reptilian omnivore that often had a litter size of 2 to 4 offspring. That's it. Today should be about celebrating the life of my dad, talking about his favorite heat rocks and terrariums, but instead, it's become one of clearing his name.
Don't you know, talking about a blue tongue skink, and it sounds like a slither. Don't you know, talking about a blue tongue skink, and it sounds like a slither. Chasing bugs and other insects, sitting on rocks, warming up in the morning. Don't you know, talking about a blue tongue skink, and it sounds like a slither. Don't you know?
Hello, America, and welcome to News from My Bedroom. Ba, 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 ba. And every day I give you the live report of what's happening on the ground in my little corner of the world, my bedroom. It's me, Sarika Bakshi, and here with me is my sassy, devil-may-care co-host, Mrs. Softy Smooch. The things you say, Miss Softy! Oh my god, you are bad.
Breaking news.
I'm Sarika Bakshi from News from My Bedroom News. I'm coming at you live from the northeast quadrant of my bedroom, aka right next to the desk, where there's been unrest as a ball of hair and a piece of fluff have been in a week-long standoff. Oh, what's that I'm hearing? The hairball and the piece of fluff seem to have put aside their differences in an exciting display of solidarity.
Come on, people now, smile on your brother, everybody get together, try to love one another.
And there you have it. We're not so different after all. Next up, we have our junior reporter, Sarika Jr., with a live report from the sock drawer.
Hey, what's up? Oh, shit.
It's me, little Sarika. Things have gotten pretty rowdy over here by the sock drawer. As you can see by me, it is overflowing with clothes. Some of it I don't even think are socks. Yesterday's laundry run may have proven too much for this IKEA drawer. Analysts predict the door will not shut. Here comes Sarika now, who promised her roommate, quote, it will definitely fit.
Yes! 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 Suck on that! Fuck you!
Whoa, that was a close one, but Sarika has done it again. How did you do it?
For a moment there, I didn't think we were gonna make it, but I guess I just kind of pushed them down.
She just kind of pushed them down. It seems not all heroes wear capes, but all of them probably wear socks. Back to you, Sarika.
What an exciting day it's shaped up to be. Closing out tonight's broadcast is Mrs. Softy Smooch with her daily dose of wisdom. Take it away, Softy.
Mrs. Softy Smooch.
You always know just what to say. Thank you for that, Mrs. Softy Smooch. Well, thank you for joining us on an unusually turbulent day in my bedroom. Tune in tomorrow where we'll get the updates on these developing stories. Where is my electric toothbrush charger? Will the Pop-Tarts we bought yesterday last through the night? And is my brother missing or just not into texting right now? All this and more tomorrow on News from My Bedroom.
Ba, 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 ba.
Look, it's a cardinal.
Oh, cool.
Honey, a cardinal is a sign of good luck.
Oh, I don't really believe in that stuff.
Oh my gosh, look. I just found $20.
Oh, well, maybe I'll find something. Oh, where did my credit card go?
Oh, a credit card. Cool.
Hello? Oh, yeah, she's right here. It's for you.
Hello? Yes, this is she. It's my boss. Uh-huh. What? A promotion? Honey, I got a promotion.
Wait, you got a promotion? Why did your boss call my phone?
Oh, you do? Okay, sure. Yeah, he's right here. All right. Honey, they want to talk to you.
Hello? Oh, you're not my boss. No, you are now? What? Your boss just fired me.
Honey, this is because you didn't believe in the sign.
Wait, the cardinal has nothing to do with this. Your boss can't fire me. What the? Babe, look!
Oh, would you look at him? He's so cute. Oh, baby.
No, he threatened me 2 seconds ago. And whose baby is that?
He's nurturing his little baby bird child. Oh, Greg, do you really expect me to believe that that sweet, innocent bird threatened you?
Honey, he's doing it again.
Oh, how beautiful. Oh, he's sending his little baby to college.
What the fuck is going on?
Greg, I know that you just lost your job like 2 minutes ago, but I kind of think you're acting a little irrational.
Honey, I swear.
Oh, would you look at that wholesome little bird? He's making a wish. Babe.
Oh, no. It's 11:11. Oh, God.
Who's there?
Shay Johnson?
Yes. What is it?
Linda Simon. FBI. Here's a voucher for an all-expenses-paid trip to Hawaii for two.
Oh, thank you. Wow.
Is your husband here by any chance?
Yeah, he's right in there.
Get him, boys.
Wait, what? Wait, what did I do? No, get your hands off of me. No.
Oh my gosh, Matt?
Matt Anderson? Dude, it's me, McGee. We took 10th grade algebra together. A lot of people call me Expo, but my real name's Exposition McGee. Dude, it's so crazy to run into you here at this carnival that you were forced to take your sister to. I had no idea it was you who was coming back to town after losing your dream job in the big city.
Yeah, I was just kicking it here at the carnival alone because we don't trust audiences these days.
Golly, 10th grade algebra.
Those were the days, huh? You'd always do this thing that you no longer do now, but you'll rediscover over the course of the movie.
Hey, walk with me. It'll give me the right amount of time to give the information needed for the story.
Your sister'll be fine. Just give her like 3/4 to play a game.
Kinda crazy thought I just had. Are you still with Kat? You broke up? She cheated on you? With the football captain? You two were so cute together, right? You remember that time you asked her to prom? You were there? You're right, I did know the cat was living in Ireland and married to an ear doctor and probably won't come up again. I don't know why I mentioned that. Sorry, it was probably just something the writer couldn't let go of. Oh, hey, how's your dad, who's the mayor and also dating one of the teachers? Good, good. He was always so nice to all of us, but always really hard on you for some reason. It's something I just feel the need to say right now. It always seemed like you were really struggling to live up to his expectations. Got that? Did he ever marry Miss Johnson? She cheated on him? With the football coach? Gosh, if I had to guess, that's probably a big point of stress in your life because he takes out all of his misery on you. Oh, that's too much exposition? Too much even for me? Oh, sorry. So I guess that's why you're moving out, huh? No, I wasn't in that scene. I just know the whole plot. Oh, hey, Sarah's back in town. It's something I'm bringing up organically. You don't remember her? She was always the talk of the town. It's a flashback. Just wait one second, this scene will come back. No, I'm not in the flashback, but I'm cool with just standing here while you think. Oh, that's crazy. Dude, you should go talk to her. It could be an incident that incites something big. Who am I looking at? No, sorry to foreshadow anything. I know you're running into Foreshadow Freddy at 2. That was supposed to be a surprise. I'm sorry. I'm nothing if not heavy-handed. Well, I should get back to standing in a corner, but dude, it was so crazy to run into you. I would say we should hang, but I know you got all this plot coming up. I guess I'll just see you at the gloomy funeral where it's raining really heavy.
Oh, my package is here.
Ugh, Amazon?
Yeah, why?
They have a pretty messed up record of abusing their employees.
Really? Damn, I should probably stop.
What? What?
It's sucking me off!
What are you talking about? Did you just come in the Amazon box?
These are difficult times, but Americans have never been afraid of difficulty.
Major combat operations in Iraq have ended.
We here at Amazon have been with you every step of the way. From the happy days to the hard ones, you've toughed it out, and we gave you what you needed with a smile. And now, we're here to give you even more. For the first time ever, our Amazon boxes will give you head.
Amazon made $386 billion in sales last year, and yet didn't pay any federal income tax, which is just really good.
Amazon warehouses report 3 times the national warehouse average for injury rates. Oh.
Warehouse workers have been forced to urinate in water bottles simply to keep up with their exhausting packing quotas, and it... No, it's really bad. Oh, fuck.
The Amazon smile is now specifically designed for anyone to climax within minutes. There's nothing Amazon won't do to keep you happy.
Isn't it a little corrupt that Obama's former press secretary, Jay Carney, is doing press release for Amazon?
Yeah, it just kind of feels like Amazon has this undue influence on our government.
Well, I mean, it really seems by any metric, Amazon is a monopoly that really needs to be broken.
Whoa! Now including prostate stimulation. Amazon. We'll come in 2 days, you come in 3 minutes.
Hi, my name is Lucy Reynolds, and I was exercised when I was 15.
Sorry, can you take off the sunglasses?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. You don't have eyes.
Oh, yeah. Did they not tell you?
No.
Oh, yeah. So, like, when I was exercised, right, they couldn't get my eyes back.
I'm sorry, what?
Oh, yeah, so, like, I had a demon inside me, right? His name was Steve. And, like, my parents, like, made him move out, you know? Because they were like, he's so much older than you. And I was like, but Mom, like, I'm 15, like, and we're in love. And so it's like, and they were like, no, it's, like, inappropriate. Like, he's gotta go. And, like, so they made me get exercise, right? And, like, he's just been a total jerk since.
What do you mean?
Oh, yeah, so, like, first he, like, took my eyes, right? Because he's totally not over me. And then he, like, moved in with my best friend, Jessica. Sorry, my ex-best friend, Jessica.
What? Okay, can you tell us what it was like?
Oh, yeah, totally. So, like, we would just do, like, normal things, you know? Like, we would, like, levitate when I would sleep. Or, like, sometimes if he didn't like what I ate for lunch, he'd make me projectile vomit. Or, like, you know, like, sometimes we just scream.
And how has your life changed?
So, like, when we were together, I did, like, so well on my Latin tests, you know? And, like, I also, like, got to sing the baritone parts in the choir. But, like, since he left, like, Jessica gets to sing them. And it's, like, ugh, makes me so mad.
And can you still see?
Oh, yeah. Like, I actually have 20/20 vision. Like, before I needed contacts, you know? But, like, then when he took my eyes, somehow my vision improved, you know? And, like, it's a good thing because, like, they're just black holes. So, like, anything I put in just kind of, like, falls in. It's like a portal to him because he's, like, so not over me.
Can we see?
Oh, no. Yeah, that would be so embarrassing. Definitely not. But, like, I do think it's funny he has to get wet every time that I shower. And, like, sometimes my friends and I will just, like, put gum in there to make him jealous, you know?
So you think your life was better when you were possessed?
Oh yeah, totally. My life is like so boring now. And like, sure, there was that time that he made me like behead my dog, you know? But like, we were just doing that to terrorize my parents, you know? Because like, they were being total jerks and like, they were like rounding us for sneaking out after curfew. But it's like, Steve goes to a satanic ritual every week. And like, if he didn't go, people would have been worried. So it's like, I'm sorry, Brownie, but like, you gotta take one for the team. Like, we're in love and like, we're gonna go every week.
So you wish you were still possessed?
Oh yeah. Like, if he begged me to come back, would I let him? Yeah. But like, would I beg him? Yeah. But like, am I also like trying to find another demon to like possess me? 100%, yeah.
So you found another demon?
Oh yeah, his name's Aaron. And like, obviously it's just a rebound possession, but like, how else am I supposed to make Steve jealous, you know?
All right. Well, thanks for joining us this week on My Paranormal Life. Next week, we'll be sitting down with real-life werewolf Jacob Schwartz. What the fuck was that? She doesn't have eyes? No. That's something that I need to know, okay? I was caught off guard. I look stupid. If I'm going to come on here and interview these wackos, then I'm going to need to know if you're going to pull some shit where she takes off her fucking sunglasses and she doesn't have eyes, okay?
I thought I was ready to start working in person again. I couldn't wait to ride the train, just like always. But then I realized something was missing. My bathroom. That's when I talked to my doctor. She prescribed Commuties, a twice-a-day treatment that lets me control when I go.
Commuties are for any adults age 21 and up who don't like holding their poo for more than an hour. They're not just diapers, they are diapers specifically designed to poo in. One Commuties can hold an average of 5 normal bowel movements. If hemorrhoids persist for longer than 4 days, seek medical help immediately. Serious side effects include reduced social interaction, dehydration, excessive questioning by law enforcement, decreased nasal capacity, and brown butt cheek syndrome. Commuties are not liable for any loss of property, employment, or relationship caused by use of the product. Tell your doctor if you experience any rumbles, blasts, bubbles, or leaks, as these might be signs of a more serious condition. Please do not sue us. We have very excellent lawyers. We will win.
Talk to your doctor today about Commuties and throw all your waste worries in the trash.
Secretary Jay Carey.
He keeps wanting to say Jim Carrey.
It's Carney's Hill.
I really like your nails too, very Eastern.
Thank you. So what's my motive? Am I like having a good time at the funeral or like am I sad?
You're like, we knew he was a lizard.
Are we on TV? I love the internet.
Partner.
I'm really debating if I should put this on my there's access, but I'm kind of like worried that people won't hire me if they see this. How's that?
Connor, you're so good at having fake orgasms.
Yeah.
It's disturbing.
Oh no! I got shot! Oh, it hurts! Oh, you shot me in the belly! Oh, you shot me in my skin! Oh god. Oh god. Okay.
What was that?
Can we reverse so my nose ring can be in the chat?
No, continuity, because we literally did the other one.
And?
No. Just go like this when you orgasm. Ah! You can't even see it. Oh. All right, Rex, get that in there. Apparently, this stupid diva wants his nose ring in the shot.
One.
Oh!